Hi. For a long time I wanted to create like a jellyfish for the garden. And finally I found some time and I'm going to do it now. So I will show you how you can create a jellyfish for your garden. Now it's up to you the size that you wish to have it. But for me, I'm going to create like a baby jellyfish using this ball, and to make sure that I'm going to remove very easy the cement after it's going to be dry from the form, I was using some oil. You can use any kind of oil, doesn't matter. So I brushed here with oil to make sure that the cement is not going to get stuck to the ball. Now to create the jellyfish, I've started here like some mesh that I have got here. I cut a piece out of it and I have got this mesh here. I tied it with a wire in a cross kind of to make sure that holds the stick. Here it's a long stick for the height that I'm looking for. And here I was using other bars, like metal bars, that I bend them a little bit to give them the feeling that you have the wavery feel of the jellyfish floating into the water. So to make sure that all the mesh and the bar, main bar, which is a supporting bar for the piece, it's going to stay together, all of them, plus the other two metals. I was tied them together. I put a little bit wire inside of the main bar and I came out with another wire, and together I was going to tie them to stay exactly the way I like. Imagine that I have to do it upside down because the cement that I'm going to pour here needs to dry out, but the piece is going to be exactly like so, right? Because that is the way that the jellyfish goes, floats into the water. So I was using this ball. I tied the wires here with the main pole, and here I prepared a little bit of cement. This is a two-part sand, one-part cement, and the water has to be runny. And why? Because when I will pour the cement here, needs to penetrate through all of the connections here to make sure that I will have them firmly in a place. So I will just remove a little bit to make sure that the cement gets everywhere, and I will try to fill up this ball. Now again, if you wish to go for this type of design, you can use any kind of ball, any size, and definitely you can just change the shape or do any other shapes that you like. But at the end, you can just use the jellyfish with the cement look, or you can improve it using the ceramic mosaic or the glass mosaic, or just painted, and according with your design in the garden, you can improve it the way that you wish. So as you can see, I'm getting close to the top of it. I'm going to just pound a little bit more to make sure that the composition gets everywhere, and I'm almost done. Now, to keep those pieces together and make them to stay together, I'm going to use two large stones that will help me to keep in place all of them. So let me just finish here with the second one, and in this way I'm sure that the weight will hold down everything here. To make a separation between the pieces here, if I wish to change the way that they will look at the end, I can use some pieces of like another stick or wood or whatever you like to make a space between the pieces here and hold the space, and in this way they will dry exactly the way that you like it. If you wish to change the position, you can change it. Anything you wish, you can do it now, because they will just stick together after 24-hour period. You can just remove everything, and that is going to help you to continue the project in the way that you like it. So I'm getting back to you to show you how you can do it further. So that is the way that absolutely the project is going to get dry, and you can improve it later the way that you like it. So here I have the jellyfish after 24-hour period. I removed the ball. It's very easy to be removed because I was using the oil here. And now because I had this main stick, I was just pushing the stick into the ground, and now has the stability that I'm looking for. And you have the other two parts that are coming out, and now I will show you how you can continue to finish this mosaic. This will be the baby jellyfish, and I have here the mother. I'm saying that it's the mother because it's a little bit bigger, and together they will create a very nice ensemble. So I'm going to show you how you can continue to finish this little piece to get close to the same look to the one that we have here on to the left. So for this one I'm using a plate. I like the color because it has this eye here in the middle, and that is going to, after I will break the ceramic, is going to give me a very nice design on this little one here. So I broke another plate here, and I save the middle, and I will just place it here on the top of it. Now, to continue to attach the pieces of the ceramic to the cement, I'm using here the tin set, and I was using the manufacturer's instructions to get to this point that, as you can see, it's very thick, stays on my knife here. So it's a very good way to attach the ceramic to the cement, and that is going to give a very good strength for the winter time, because I'm keeping those ones, of course, in the garden, and I don't want to just use them for this summer to be nice in the garden. I want to have them for years that are coming. So I'm using a blob of this tin set. I'll cover entirely the piece here of the ceramic, and I'll just place it here on top of it. And now, from the broken ones that I got here, that I already broke the pieces, I was using those nipples, which are very good. The pointed one, you have to just push on the piece of the ceramic, and it's going to break immediately. Very easy. Now I'm going to try to put all the way around the pieces of the ceramic that I have them here already, and try to continue the little design here that I have. So for this one, I'm going to just make it smaller and just put a little bit blob of the tin set and attach it to the piece here. So it's going to continue the design exactly the way that you can see it here. You have it at the top with a little bit eye, and that eye continues with the stripes all the way, are coming bigger and bigger to the end of the piece here. So I will continue just to attach all of them. And for this part here, because as you can see, I have here to cover the metal part here, I'm just using again a longer piece of the ceramic, put a big blob of the tin set, and just attach it to the piece here. and that is going to just stick here. I'll just align a little bit to make sure that I'm getting the what is not needed here. And in the same way, I'm going to use for the other part here, because as you can see, I've done it here. Jellyfish has kind of wavery things coming out from the big body, and I'm using again a very long piece, but you can go with smaller ones, it's up to you, no problem. And I will just attach them to this part of the, this is the reason that I put in the cement those wires, to make sure that I will continue with the design. So here I will go again for another piece, and I will just continue the design all the way around, and that is going to give me a finished look of the design. I'm trying to use the same pattern to have the lines coming from the center down to the end of the piece. So I'll go all the way around in this way, and after I will finish, I will just get back to you to show you further step what you need to do to finish this ensemble. So here is the baby jellyfish the next day after the it's dry. So all the pieces of tiles are now in place, are not moving, are strong. And now I'm going to use the grout. I will use a white grout. I won't change the color, as always I'm doing it, because of course I want to keep the white look for the entire piece. So here the grout, it's this consistency, it's very thick, kind of, it's like a thick yogurt, and that is because needs to get between the pieces of ceramic, but in the same time they need to the grout needs to stay in place very well. So I will just use a piece of plastic, and I will just wipe, like a smear, a little bit here and there, the grout that goes in any crevices here, and I will just wait for the grout to have an haze on it, like needs to dry probably 15-20 minutes after that, to create that haze on top of it. So when I will see the haze, it means that I can come with a wet sponge that I have it here ready, and I will just can wipe the piece, so it's going to remain clean for the grout. And to get the shininess of it, I'm going to use a dry cloth, and I will shine every single piece of the ceramic. After I will use the grout on all the piece, I'm going to just wait another 24-hour period, and I will just use this sealer. And that is because I'm keeping the pieces outside in a garden for the winter, and this sealer, it's helping me a lot to preserve those pieces probably for years they are coming now, and they will not be destroyed by the harsh winter that we have here in Canada. So after I will finish to grout this second piece, I will show you the way that the ensemble looks at the end. So I finished the baby jellyfish, and as you can see now, they are together, looking very happy, I think, and me even more, because I'm very pleased with the way that the entire structure came. So as you can see, from any angle they are looking very nice. You can just enjoy with the view from any side of the garden. So again, I'm extremely happy. So that started from some wire that I had it in a garden for a long time. I didn't need them. They were like a poles, metal poles for my tomatoes, and they were rusted and I was ready to throw them away. So I was thinking that still I need to give them a chance. So I tried to create the tentacles out of them, as I showed you. And I just bent here and there each of them, and I got to this feeling that they are floating into the water, like it's like a deep water. So the stones at the base, I painted them with a color that I was thinking that it's in a deep sea, deep ocean. And when you'll get close to them, they will give you the feeling that indeed you are in close to the seaside or ocean side. So again, you can create a very nice design for your garden using your imagination and very little cement. So with some spare dishes, all together they came very nice. So again, I'm very pleased with the way that they look now. So definitely it's a nice focal point to my garden. If you wish more inspirational ideas for your home or for your garden, please check on my channel. I have mosaic, cement, cinder blocks, 3D wall art, how can you create a tall or large pot, and many more. So I will be more than happy if you wish to request some questions regarding my projects. Definitely more than happy to share any ideas or information with you. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm hoping that you are safe. I wish you a very good day. Thank you. Goodbye.